All right, so here we are on Waystation in the second match of today's group stage. In the bottom right corner of the map, it is going to be the yellow Protoss Genji Takiya from France playing his heart out as Protoss, everybody's favorite race. And there we go. Odin, how about you introduce the top left player?
Yep, spawning at the top left-hand side from Team Cascade. It's going to go ahead and be the German player Hanfi spawning as the pink Zerg, which is, of course, not everybody's favorite race, because I'm a Terran player, but it's pretty close, and PvZ is exciting, and I gotta say, I love that logo he's got going for him for Team Cascade. It looks like a tiger or a panther of the sort, and it looks really, really cool.
Nice. I'm zooming in on it. So we're actually using GameHeart as an observer interface, and as an extension mod for these lobbies, which of course lets you show team logos that actually have been actually put into GameHeart. Not all team logos are in there, but that gets you nice little nifty things. Also, like the Dutch StarCraft League logo right in the middle of the map here. I love that detail.
Yep, and I mean it's also really good on occasion when I don't think we really see it right now, but. It's a very good way to give the sponsor some exposure in a lot of teams, like the professional teams, Team Liquid, for example. They'll have all of their sponsors next to the main building at the beginning of the game, so you really get some exposure for those guys when they're being streamed, and that's it's really cool on those features.
And actually important. Of course, you might say, "Well, this is a game. We don't want to see sponsor logos in there." But remember, like our sponsor, CM Storm, which you can actually see. If you look at the bottom right corner of your screen, that is our Cooler Master logo, and that's not there without a reason. That's there for a reason, I was going to say. Because Cooler Master, in a very real sense, makes the entire Dutch StarCraft League possible. They actually borrow us a big set of computers for the players to play their matches on at the live events, multiple, I should say. And of course, they also contribute financially to the league, and it doesn't cost that much money to run a league, but you know, it's still not free, and without them, it wouldn't have been possible.
Yep, and always a huge shout out to our sponsors, bringing those games back to you guys at home. And all you gotta do is watch those games, tell your friends about them. And I mean, with the lineup we've got going for you for the next couple of weeks, this is gonna be some games you don't want to miss, in all honesty. And of course, on this map, we do see right now Hanfi going for two hatcheries. I think that was even before before the pool, maybe. I'm not 100% sure. Yep. I just checked the times. That was two hatcheries before the pools. And on this map, it can be a little tricky, Frank, because there's a lot of positions where you can do some damage. If you check the third base he took, you will see that there's a lot of high ground surrounding that base, and it's also quite far away from the natural. So if you ever want to do a good two base timing or put some aggression on with four gateways early on, this is a pretty good time for Genji Takiya to make that happen.
Yep, of course, if he scouts it. But what are the signs for Genji to realize that there's a third hatchery down when he arrives with his cell at this natural?
Oh, he shouldn't even have to scout it. He should already know, because he saw the timing on the pool, which was awkwardly late. That timing on the pool that was really, really way too late to be a pool after the first expansion. So he should know exactly what's going on, and he's actually targeting an overlord in the middle of the map, but deciding not to pick that off because. He's gonna get all of his units to the front. Nope, he's still targeting. I like that, because that's gonna supply block Hanfi a little bit, and I'm always a little bit scared when I see this kind of build, especially on a map like this. So we're gonna have to see Hanfi put on a very good defense. He's making some Zerglings already, two queens on their way, but there's not gonna be nearly enough creep spread towards that base. But it looks like Genji Takiya is backing off for now. He is having a pile of, probe on the map, though, on the top side.
Yep, definitely. This probe's looking like it's gonna throw down a pylon, which of course will allow Genji Takiya to warp in some units very close to his enemy's third base. And like you said, there's no creep connecting the third base. In fact, it's a very, very long distance between the third base and the natural, which means that it's very difficult for queens and other defenses to get over there to the third base. So I'm curious to see what Genji's doing, but so far Genji seems kind of defensive.
Nice. He's setting up for a two-base push, which I think is the best thing here. You already get a little bit of a win. He forced out some Zerglings. You know, even just getting the Zealot and the Stalker across the map, you're going to force out a lot of defenses. There's also Spore Crawlers on the way, and he's making a robotics facility, which has been unscouted by the Zerg, even though it's at the front of the base. So he could just go for a good timing with some Immortals, a two-base Immortal timing, and I feel like he would do a lot of damage, at least kill the third.
Wait, was the Robo Bay not scouted? I think it was scouted, but maybe he didn't click it.
Oh, no. You're right. He did scout it. I never saw any units.
Yeah, there was a flock of Zerglings running up to the front right before this second gateway was thrown up there.
Right, so he should know what that surprises me. Why is he throwing down spore crawlers? Huh? That seems a little bit odd here, but nonetheless, 10 Zerglings on the way. Actually, he's not capitalizing on those tree bases a lot, but he is getting a little bit of extra income. He's not mining a lot of gas, and if it's gonna be just Zergling, it's gonna be a little bit hard to defend. I feel like he is adding one extra extractor. A lot of times you'll see, if possible, Hydra Zergling to defend this. He is making a lair, so there is the possibility of that.
Huh. Yeah, so what is his plan for all these Zerglings that he's making right now? Because he's not gonna break this wall with only Zerglings.
I think it's just for defensive purposes, I would say. Maybe catch the army when it moves out. Maybe try to position them close to his opponent's base. He is moving in and out with the Zerglings. So it's actually revealing that he has quite a lot of them, but he should know that there's no way he's ever doing damage to this.
Mm-hmm. Alright. Talking about it. So he knows there's a two-base push coming. Oh, there's actually closing off of the wall once again, but it's not a permanent closing off. There's a zealot there to hold the wall. It's not a pylon.
He's actually moving out right now, and the Zerglings are probably going to be to try and counterattack right now, but it's not going to work. And they could start to try and attack the army from the back, but there's not that much creeps, bro. He does have speedlings, so they're going to be fast regardless, but he's going to try and hold this up with just the Zerglings. So the Immortals' extra damage against armor is not going to be that useful. He might catch these two Stalkers. That would be a good start for Henry, and some decent force fields pushing them back a little bit. He has to be careful though. He needs a lot of Zealots here, and he doesn't really have those. He will lose some of these units. I feel like good surround with the Zerglings, and Takiya is not really expecting this at all, but he is still trading pretty good.
Yeah. And the attack at the front is now completely dissipated. All the Zerglings there have gone down. So this is just defend for Hanfi. And even though he got the great surrounds, it still didn't do a lot of damage with the first wave of Zerglings.
Yeah, I mean, he is getting a pretty good surround again, but the force fields are excellent from Genji Takiya. Most of the damage is going on the Immortals, and they do have 300 HP, so it's going to be hard to break with just Zerglings, especially with the amount of Zealots that's still there.
Emergency spine crawlers coming down. Will they finish on time, or do you think Genji is just going to walk over to the third base and take that down?
It's going to be up to the Hydras. He really wanted to go for the Zergling Hydras, but this attack, usually it only hits around the 10:30 mark, or at least like around the 10-minute mark, I feel like, and it attacked pretty fast with it, with the Immortal push, and it just caught him off guard a little bit. He never had the Hydras, he just had the Zerglings, and they're not enough, and now the Hydras are going to come in from all different angles, and he's going to lose this base for sure, and I feel like if he loses this base, that could be it.
Well, he did kind of anticipate losing this base, because he's making a macro hatch in his main base, so he will not lose all the production that he had of three bases. But yeah, like you said, of course, the mining here is gone. Oh, there's a spore crawler actually doing some damage on the mothership core.
Yeah, I mean, the hatchery in the main base is going to offer the larva, but he doesn't nearly have enough gas to make a lot of hydras, because hydras are quite gas-intensive units early on in the game, and he did lose a lot, and right now the supply is still in favor of Genji Takiya, and this is looking pretty bad for the German Zerg player in game number one.
Huh. Yeah, he did take out one of the reinforcement pylons there, but there's more left right near the watchtower is going to be the first one. So like you said, good position for Genji here, who's not expanding himself, by the way, and also seems to be retreating. So what is his deal here? Is he going to be reinforcing and then attacking again, or what is he going to do?
I don't know. I mean, Genji Takiya really has the cards in his hand. If this was a match of poker, he really has the full house, and his opponent is just holding a pair. And that's not the position you want to be in, because he just wants to get rid of the pylons to move out a little bit. And ideally, he wants to establish a new third base. And Genji Takiya can really do whatever he wants. He can try to kill his opponent, or he could just grab a third base and macro off if he so desires. Because once ahead, get more ahead.
So do you think maybe, because there's Colossi popping out now, you think Genji's waiting for one or two Colossi with extended thermal lance and then maybe start raining down some damage on these spore crawlers from afar?
I don't think the spore crawlers are the main concern. I feel like the Hydras are what really is making him doubt the situation just a little bit. I feel like taking a third base behind this could be possible, but he doesn't need to do it. He's ahead in supply, and I feel like he knows the position he's in. So, like you said, should be the magic number of two Colossi with the terminal lens. If maybe he could also wait for the +1 weapons, but I think that's a little bit too far away. Terpe is actually coming up, so he's making sure about everything. I like the play from Genji, very safe, but...
And immediately a kind of a counterattack from Hanfi might actually cancel this third base. There's no pylons here to warp in units yet. Yeah, this might actually need to be cancelled.
Yep, there's a Colossus coming to save the day, and he has to be a little bit careful with the Colossus, but should be okay, especially with the Zealots moving up. But it's a little bit of a win for Hanfi, and being Hanfi, you really need to get everyone. He actually forces the entire army back, and he's finally gonna kill that nasty pylon in the middle of the map. Got a decent amount of roaches adding to the army as well, and I mean, Hanfi is still very much behind, but he's still trying for it.
Yeah, but he's re-establishing his third base, but of course likewise is Genji, who is still ahead in supply, and of course ahead in tech as well. Actually, as I say that, there's also Vipers coming down now from Hanfi, so if he can pull maybe the Colossi out of this army and kill them with the Hydras really fast, I'm gonna say this is gonna come down to the engagement.
The Vipers, they don't have the energy. It's very good surround strategy here from Hanfi. Actually got Zergling in an ideal angle, and the Hydralisk in a good angle as well. However this battle is going to go, it's going the best it could for Hanfi here. The Vipers, of course, never having the energy needed, but he did pretty good there, surprisingly.
Supplies have evened out a little bit, but that's, of course, not where you want to be as a Zerg player with not having a functional third base right now. I think this macro hatch in his main really did save Hanfi. Without that, he would not have held there.
I mean, Hanfi showing just excellent army position. I'm really taking the best possible engagement, and that's what the only thing he can do, because he's just so far behind in that position, and he's like, well, I'm just gonna do the best I can, and he did so well there, and he actually is putting this game back a little bit. It's becoming possible to make something happen again, because he's got two Vipers right now. They've got a lot of energy. They could start putting these Colossus, and that's not where you want to be in, but he has to be careful. He's running into the army head on right here. That's not where he wants to be.
Nope. No, these armies clash. There's only one victor, and it's the Protoss.
Yeah, if he gets into a good position, a good concave, he could make something happen. He's trying it. He's moving the roaches down. He was on a good pull. Good first pull. That
nice second pull.
Definitely.
Third
second
pull. Fourth pull. What? But none of the Colossi got... Oh, actually one. Wow.
That was some good pulling, but not the DPS needed to really take them all down. And even though, once again, he's making a very good situation out of a hard one, it's just barely not enough.
Right, so you think maybe he could have better not pull all three, but pull one or two, so that the damage was focused on these one or two instead of the three, so that now none of them went down?
I think four Colossus was just a little bit too much for Hanfi there to handle. He tried his best, but it's more than he bargained for. And
these Vipers really pulled more than they could chew.
Yep, that's exactly how I would describe it, actually. And I mean, Genji Takiya just still in a very good spot. He's three bases against three bases, and even though Hanfi is securing his third base, it's gonna be a hard ride for him, but he's holding on, and he's really showing that Hanfi is an excellent player.
Yeah, definitely. He's not giving up, hallmark of a good player. Also not mining gas very efficiently at his third base there. But like his fourth base also coming up, this is starting to look like a game that is actually not in that bad of a shape for Hanfi. I think Genji has given Hanfi enough time an opportunity to catch back up.
Well, he's given him a fighting chance, and the real disparity right now for the players, I would say, is still a little bit of tech, because there is High Templars on the way, which is going to be very good for Genji Takiya, but especially just the upgrade department, because we've already got +3 weapons underway for Genji Takiya, and on the other side of things, we just got +1 attack, and the Protoss can just have so much damage output, especially with the Immortals and the Colossi, with that +2 damage and +3 incoming, so it's going to be a little bit difficult for Hanfi, but he's giving himself a fighting chance, and I really like to see this.
Mm-hmm. And lots of upgrades coming down from Genji Takiya. Like you said, ground weapons level 3 already down, coming up. So it's going to be a hard one. So tell me again about the upgrades, right? The armor upgrades reduce damage, of course. Weapon upgrades increase damage. But there's lots of situations where getting an armor or getting a weapons upgrade makes more sense than the other one, right? So if you do two attacks, for example.
Yeah, if you do two attacks, you'll do +2 damage instead of +1, and some units just get more damage increase, and we do have a little bit of skirmish back and forth. Like, for example, an Immortal will do more damage with an extra upgrade. I think it starts with, 50 damage or something, and it gets +5 against armor each level, or something crazy like that, so then it's really better. Like, for Protoss, in general, it's a lot better in most situations, except if you're doing something with Zealots and a Guardian Shield, for example, then defenses can be very good. But most situations, you'll go for the damage upgrades. And we do have an engagement coming down here pretty shortly. Hemphy's almost maxed out, but a lot of that is in Roaches. There are two Ultralisks coming, actually, which surprises me a little bit. They don't have the armor upgrades, but they are still a little bit scary here. And the Spine Crawlers are actually moving to the wrong position.
Hallucinated Colossus among this army. Yep. This is looking like a tremendously big army from the Protoss. Great position from the Zerg though. Oh, lots of pulls! Look at this!
Yep, and actually a really good blinding cloud as well in the middle of that army. But some storms going down as well. And those storms are changing the weather of this fight. But it looks like the Zerg could actually maybe do this. It's getting close to that to that part. He's holding on very bravely here. And there's one more Colossus in the back and a lot of Stalkers. And the Hydras are doing a good job. But he's just barely pushing through here, and I don't know if the 25 Roaches can hold it. It's gonna be very close.
They're popping out one at a time. Some of them popping out here and back. Nearly getting taken out right away. There's reinforcements from Genji coming up as well.
I don't think he's gonna... Like, all of these Hydras are so low health that actually they're all being sniped right now. And the Roaches against the Blinkstalkers, they're not gonna trade well. And the supplies look even right now, but a lot of that supply is in Roaches. And like we already mentioned, they don't have the same upgrades, and they don't have Blink either, which would be amazing on Roaches, but they don't. And he's just losing more and more supply. He loses the hatch, and this could be the nail in the coffin here, Frank.
Yeah, I think so, too. This is a losing battle for Hanfi, because his units are just spawning in, or warping in, or what do you call that, popping out, right on top of the, right below the Protoss army.
Yep, I mean, they're popping out from every hatchery, so they're coming across from all bases. It's very hard to reinforce this from Hanfi, although he did do a pretty good job on the creep scrub, but I have to commend Takiya here. That was some really, really good Blink Stalker control right there.